We are entering the wrapping stage. I want you to keep in mind that a promise is a try-catch wrapper around code that will finish at an unpredictable time. Here, let me show you an example. Promise is a constructor. You can either store a promise as a variable, like I'm doing right here, or you can simply work on it as soon as you create it. Either way works just fine, but you'll often see me simply work on the promise without storing it as a variable. You pass a function to the promise with two arguments, resolve and reject. Resolve and reject are two callbacks that you use to specify when a promise has either fulfilled because something worked or rejected because something went wrong. Let me show you what this actually looks like. In this example, I'm wrapping an image tag loader in a promise because I want to do some work after the image loads on the page. I'm using the image tag's onload handler to specify success. Onload calls resolve, which queues up the function passed to then to execute after this function finishes executing. Note, the JavaScript engine does not immediately stop executing this function upon calling resolve. In this case, that's the last piece of work, so effectively it's the end of the function. However, that's not always the case. Check the link in the instructor notes to see what I mean. Being able to call resolve and reject is important. This is what gives you the flexibility to explicitly say what constitutes fulfillment and what constitutes rejection for the promise. When either resolve or reject has been called, the promise has been settled. And then at that point, the next part of the chain, usually a .then, or it could be a .catch, is then executed. Back to the original example, any value passed to resolve or reject will be received as an argument by this subsequent .then or .catch. In the event that nothing is passed to resolve or reject, as is the case here with reject, then it's totally fine. The next link in the chain simply receives undefined. There's a third case, and that is if the value that's passed is a promise. If so, then the promise will execute first, and then whatever value it resolves to will be passed to the next link in the chain. Note that resolve and reject have the same syntax. Resolve leads to the next then in the chain, while reject leads to the next catch. Incidentally, if there is a JavaScript error somewhere in the body of the promise, .catch will also automatically get called. And by the way, there's a bit more to error handling, and you'll be learning about it in the next lesson. In the meantime, it is time for you to write your first promise.